Well, moving on, as we batten down for long periods of uncertainty ahead, just how much of an impact is the coronavirus crisis having on us as a nation? New figures reveal 90% of us have been affected personally by COVID-19.
The most common feeling we have is being anxious, but more than a quarter of us are feeling hopeful as well. And almost half of us think that things won't be back to normal for at least 7 months. Well, demographer and strategist Mark McCrindle joins us now. Good morning to you, Mark. Good to see you. Now, the majority of us have been impacted by this virus. I'm interested who the 10% who say that they haven't been are. The biggest impact for Australians can be in the shopping aisles.
That's right, Mon. 7 in 10 Australians have been unable to buy what they wanted at the supermarket, our report has shown. And this has come about because of just a small proportion, 6% of Australians, who did that stockpiling and left us with the empty shelves. That actually created a bit of panic buying in another 30% of Australians who bought a bit more than they ordinarily would, and that left the aisles bare for the rest of us. No surprise to find that 94% of Australians say that there should be some restrictions or at least self-restraint when it comes to buying. We shouldn't just buy whatever we want.
And Mark, your research has shown that the older generations who are more vulnerable to coronavirus are actually coping better in these times.
It's amazing to see, isn't it? You know, more than half of all Generation Zs, those in their teenage and 20-something years, say that they are extremely or very concerned as they look to their future. They're uncertain, whereas that was just 1 in 4 of the baby boomers feeling this high-level uncertainty about the future. Similarly, when we looked at the loneliness that this isolation is causing, 2 in 5 Gen Zs said that they are feeling concerned about the loneliness from that compared to just 1 in 4 of the older baby boomers. And also things like mental resilience and how we're going emotionally. More than half of the Generation Zs expressed concerns there compared to less than half of the baby boomers feeling less resilient. So, you know, the baby boomers are well set up in this time, even though they might in some ways be more vulnerable to the COVID issue.
Yeah, and I guess that they've seen it before. You know, many of them were children, you know, of the war, where their parents went off to war. So, yeah, I guess they've been through that before. We have to find a silver lining in all of this, Mark, don't we? And there, it seems that people are feeling some benefits to the social isolation.
That's right. You know, our study showed that we're definitely doing less physical activity, or a significant proportion of Australians are, and there's an increased reporting on boredom as well. But 1 in 3 Australians say that they're getting into activities that otherwise they wouldn't. Getting back into some old pastimes, reading is on the rise, baking at home is up, people pursuing creative pursuits is up as well across almost a third of Australians, and some online learning. You know, people just using this time to grow their knowledge and skills was a very much a positive as well.
I've thought long and hard, Mark, about increasing my physical activity. I don't know whether that counts or whether it was a category you looked at. What about embracing working from home? How are Australians faring there?
Well, we've been forced into it, but again, a silver lining in that as well, Matt. We had 8 in 10 Australians saying that they think that this will be the new normal, this remote working and the online learning for the kids as well, so get used to more of it. 7 in 10 Australians said that they actually are as productive or more productive when working from home than at the office, so that's a positive thing. We feel that not only is it the new normal, but, you know, we can cope pretty well. Now, I think there are a lot of us in this boat. In fact, more than half of Australians said that they do feel the challenge, though, of juggling the home front with kids working from home and also other household members working from home. And so 56% saying juggling that is a bit of a challenge, although we see the benefits from this online working as well.
Yes, indeed. I think that we're going to hold on to a lot of it. How do Australians feel about our government and how our government has responded to the crisis?
Well, very positively as well overall. The most trusted sites that we're going to for information are those government sites and apps that are then represented through social media. People are looking for the source of that information. And also, for those who say that, well, almost 8 in 10 say the government is doing a good job on this compared to other nations. In fact, for everyone who says they're doing worse than other countries, twice as many are saying that the government is doing better than we're seeing in other countries. So that's a good vote of confidence as well.
Mark McCrindle, it is always good to talk to you. Fascinating to hear how people are feeling at the moment. Thank you so much.
Thank you.